Pithawalla, and today I'm going to tell you all the story of my journey from about how I came to be an actor. I was born in India, but I lived in Dubai for 10 years since my dad, you know, he was working in Dubai. So me, my mom and dad, we lived in Dubai. So I used to watch Bollywood films, I remember. So my grandmom, my nani, she was a big, big Bollywood fan. When I was a kid, I used to love to dance on Choli Ke Piche Kya Hai. So I think I was a Madhuri Dixit fan. Then I started watching films and, you know, like old films like Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, all of that, Dil To Pagal Hai. I think as a child, I was a 90s kid, so for every 90s kid, these movies have been like iconic. So same for me, it was same for me. And I developed a passion for dancing. And then I grew up, then my mom put me for classes as I was growing up. So I did a lot of dance classes, which involved like Bollywood and, you know, contemporary jazz. I started training in dancing because I felt like that's probably what I want to do when I grow up, since I enjoy it so much. I remember when I used to go to theaters and watch movies, I think every child or every person has felt that, you know, when you watch some like heroine on the screen and you're like, someday I would probably like to be there. When I was in college, in my 11th grade, 11th or 12th grade, I had a friend who was like from my society, and he was assisting a film producer and a director on a film project. She asked him that, do you know anyone, because we're looking for a girl, because the actor they had finalized backed out last minute. So they didn't have anyone on board. So he showed her my pictures on Facebook because I somehow fit the look that they were looking for. And she really liked the pictures. So she was like, yeah, why don't you call this girl and, you know, we'll take her audition and let's see kaise hota hai. So I said, okay, I told my mom about it. She was like, she's always been supportive. Like my parents right from the beginning have been supportive because they knew I was not so great at academics. And I knew for a fact that I am not cut out for like a 9-to-9 job or I can't do that. So I knew I'll do something in the creative field. So she's like, why not? Give it a shot. Let's see what happens. There's no harm in trying. And I did an audition, which was very bad. According to me, it was very bad because obviously I didn't know to act. I was nervous, I was conscious, and you know, I must have given a lot of retakes. So I knew I was not getting the part. Around 8-9 o'clock in the night, they called me. Okay, again my friend called and he said, you know what, they liked you very much and they want you to be a part of the film. So can you come to the office to sign the contract? And this was like a proper Bollywood feature film. So I couldn't believe it. I said, are you kidding? Like, don't joke with me. He's like, no, for real, they actually want you on this film. So I said, okay, I told my mom and she's like, yeah, see, I knew it. I told you, you're going to get the part. I said, okay, let's see now what happens. It had established actors. It had Neil Nitin Mukesh and Richa Chadda as the lead pair. And I was playing their friend. It was like a college love story romance. Right now it is on Amazon Prime. It's called Ishkeria. So this was actually my first project, which I shot when I was 18, I think, yeah, 17 or 18. So that's where it started from. And during the shoot, I had a lot of fun. They were really helpful, really sweet. Like they helped me a lot because I was very bad at it. I had not taken any training before that, no acting classes, nothing. So that was like my literally first, you know, like my baby step, I could say. So it was fun and I really enjoyed the process and I figured that, you know, it's not that difficult. Probably if I take training, if I audition more, if I meet more people and, you know, trying to get into the industry, maybe it will work out for me. Because this just happened, I did not plan it at all. When I did the film, it was easy, it just fell into my lap. But then, when I stepped out into the like real world, it was difficult. I would audition, I would give like probably 200, 300 ad auditions a month and not get a call back, maybe get 2-3 calls back that, you know, okay, you're shortlisted, but then you don't get finalized. So that happens a lot also. So then you're like, initially, obviously, I used to get very disappointed. I think every actor gets disappointed when you don't get a call back. So I was like, oh my God, am I really cut out for this? Did I just leave everything for this? Like, you know, is it the right path? You start doubting yourself, questioning yourself. But then I thought, you know what, it's still, let me give it time. In this field and in this industry, I would say you need a lot of patience. Few months, I didn't get any calls. Then after like 4-5 months, I started getting shortlisted and then they were like, okay, you're finalized and the budget and whatever. So then I started, I think my first ad was a Spice Jet ad. So then I started giving more auditions for films, for serials, I remember, and web series and stuff started coming in too. Then my first big break after the film was a show called Warrior High. It was a fiction show. But that time I had just done the film, so I wasn't sure, should I pick on like a fiction show or wait for other films to come in? But then my friends were like, you know what, you're getting it on a platter, might as well do it. I had cold feet because I knew this was like a fiction show that's a daily show which goes on like Monday to Friday and you have to shoot back to back. And I know that the shooting hours are crazy and you know, I'll be required for probably 12 hours, 14 hours overtime and all of that. But I said, okay, I'll just do it. And then I started, and that show, I think I could say, has given me lot of love and lot of fame. And I have a lot of fans, all of them just remember that show of mine. Like that's one of my work which like everyone remembers. And that show went on for a year. And then through that, I started, like, people started recognizing me then. You know, I never thought, like, as a normal person, you don't think that, you know, if you do something, like, people are going to, like, come up to you, talk to you and whatever, want a picture with you. So that was a big deal. And I started, like, it started sinking in that, okay, I think I am cut out for this, maybe. So then I started getting more ads. I did around 15, 20 ads. I did Cadbury, Clean and Clear. Then I did Subway, I did a Jolly Rancher ad, like a lot of them. I started doing workshops because I figured that I didn't want to enroll myself in like an acting school that would take like 2 years or 3 years of my time and then, you know, so I thought like might as well work as well as learn at the same time. So that would be more easier maybe, I felt that would work. So I started doing workshops. I did this workshop with a very established actor known as Neeraj Kabi. His classes were really good. They helped me a lot. It was like an intense 10-day course, which was for like 3 hours every day. There I met more friends and he really helped me overcome my probably my nervousness and, you know, being conscious and facing the camera and all of that, because I started getting a little more confident as I was doing work, as I was working and, you know, taking these classes. So that helped me a lot. Then he suggested to go to Pondicherry for one of these classes. It's called as Adi Shakti. It happens in Pondicherry and it's a very old theatre group actually. And it was founded by this lady called Veena Pani, who is no more. So every year, I think twice, they take a batch, they select a batch of 20 students from all over India and all over the world, in fact. So a lot of foreigners also come down to do that course. So I had sent them a mail because it's apparently you cannot sign up for it. Like you mail them and then they select whoever they feel is suitable for the workshop. That workshop really helped me. Not only in acting, but learning about myself, opening up and seeing how wide actually the field is. Because sometimes you're just like, okay, you have to act, it can be done in just one way, but that's not it. It can be done in a lot of different ways. So just exploring yourself and your style and your technique, because every actor has their own way. So then I started doing music videos. Since I was also into dancing, that has always been like a plus for me. That was fun. Then I started doing sketches. So there's this channel called TVF, which I'm sure mostly everyone has heard of. And they have another channel in, which is a sub-channel called Girly Appa, which basically focuses on videos about females and ladies. So I liked helping them out, so I worked with them as well. We did like a couple of sketches, which are on YouTube. And that did really well also. Then I did another web show called The Great Indian Dysfunctional Family, which I had auditioned for and I got the part, and it was on Alt Balaji, this platform. And that was a great experience again, because that show, the character that I played was very different to whatever I've done before. The role was of a lesbian girl and she's in love with another girl, and how her family doesn't like her because she's lesbian when they get to know, and her father cannot accept it at all. So he literally likes, and she's a rebel because she is what she is and she tells them upfront, but they don't like, you know, support her and they want to get her married and stuff. So how she actually goes and gets like cuts her hair as a boy cut just to show everyone that, you know, I am what I am and you must accept me the way I am and I'm not going to change. So that was very different from what I am as a person. But when you're not that person you're playing, to make the audience believe that, oh, that is you, it's very difficult, trust me. So I did a lot of homework, I could say. So before the show started, I started watching a lot of movies that had characters like those, especially Hollywood ones, because in Bollywood, there aren't many like those, and especially good ones. So I started watching a few Hollywood films that had it, picked some stuff from it, then watched videos online, all of that, and I tried to make something that I could make mine. And thankfully, it turned out very well, because I was really scared that what if people don't like it? Like, it could either go well or it could go bad. There was no in-between in that character. And I had, my father was played by KK Menon sir, And I would say I've learned a lot from him, just observing him. If you're an actor, the struggle never ends. It's like you have to audition, that's how you grow. So it's not only like, okay, if I've done 10 films, I'm a great actor. It's never like that, because the struggle is real. You keep auditioning. As an actor, I love auditions. I mean, I don't like people who tell me that, you know, I want the part, but I don't want to audition for it. My family has been my biggest support. Without them, I would have never been able to reach where, you know, right now I am. And my whole journey would never be possible without them, because they supported me right from day one. And they never forced me into anything. Only my dad was just like, just do your graduation so that tomorrow you have a backup if this doesn't work out for you, but otherwise you can follow your dreams. So I did that. I did my graduation in psychology and sociology. So tomorrow, if I, you know, want to do that as well, I can move maybe to that. And my mom always believed in me more than anything. And I hope to continue with this journey and hopefully do better roles, better films, and, you know, better things. But I think most importantly, more than anything, if you're not a nice human being, then there's no point. I mean, there's no point about anything. So I've tried to do that all my life. Do good, be good to people, help others, do good karma, all of that. Because I think karma is very important. If you do good, you get good, which is what I believe in. And I believe in God. So I'm trying to do my best in everything. And I hope I get good as well. This is my journey and this is my story. Thanks.